What's up, everybody, and welcome to Robeytech post-vacation edition. Though I didn't go on vacation, that man did. Yeah, he went on vacation. Luckily, I had to stay here and be alone without recording any YouTube videos, and I know that made you guys very sad. But alas, we are back. We are back, and we are going to do something that many people have asked for. So the 1K, like what is the best PC to buy for $1,000, was a very, very, very popular edition. And so we decided to follow that up with another video because some people said, hey Robey, what do I need to upgrade? Hey Robey, what's the best part to do? What if I have a little bit more money? So like I promised when I talked about that series initially, we're gonna do one video that's $1,000, one video that's $2,000, and then one ultimate PC edition. Now, don't get me wrong, we're not gonna do like $15,000. It'll probably be in the $3,000 to $5,000 range and then kind of talk about the best parts to upgrade. But in this video, we are here specifically to talk about the 2K version. And trust me, you're gonna wanna stick around for this entire video because there's gonna be lots of hints and tips on what I did to select the pieces that I chose specifically for this part. Now, make sure you let us know in the comments below. Tell us, what did you think about the parts I chose? All that sort of stuff. And then at any individual part, let me know. Would you do it a little bit different? Because guess what? For this particular one, there are a lot of options. Spending 2K is really hard. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about where you can kind of go off the rails and where you wanna stay on the rails. And the best thing about it is we got something super special at the very end that we're gonna talk about specifically with this build. You're gonna wanna stick around because there's some really great stuff and some info you're gonna want at the end of the video. Let us start off with the brain of the operation, and that is the AMD Ryzen 7 3700X 8-core 16-thread 3.6 gigahertz CPU. Now, as you may know from the 1K video, there is a reason that I cannot recommend Intel at this point in time. And I know Intel fanboys, you're gonna be super mad. I love Intel, I have Intel right here, we have Intel everywhere, I got a 9900K. I like Intel too, they are the king of the gaming system. But when we're talking about a new PC, here's the problem. There are rumors that 3000 series Nvidia will support PCIe Gen 4. AMD is also already supporting PCIe Gen 4. PCIe Gen 4 is only on the AMD platforms right now. As of early 2020, what is it? It's February 13th. We do not have a PCIe Gen 4 supported Intel processor. So that's why I'm doing AMD Ryzen 3700X. Now, some people might say, why not the 3800X? Why not the 3900X? Well, those are much more pricey. This is a great CPU. At the time we were looking at this, it was $309.99. It may, in terms of being able to do 1440p gaming, which is kind of what I'm targeting here, that is an ideal kind of classification. If you were gonna go up to like a 3800X or 3900X, you're kind of starting to get into the 4K range in terms of 4K graphics. You don't, there's not really enough bang for buck in this kind of configuration that going any higher than that. So that's my recommendation, AMD Ryzen 7 3700X 8-core CPU. $309.99 right now on Newegg. You can check that out. For the motherboard, we did the Gigabyte X570 RS Elite. First thing that I had to do, like when we talked about in the 1K version, I didn't have USB-C. I wanted to have front panel USB-C and specifically USB-C 3.2 Gen 2 support on the motherboard. That was super critical to me. Given all of the extra support, like for instance, Seagate's new game drive and all that sort of stuff, I wanted to make sure that you could use all of those fast transfer rates and anything that's coming out with USB-C, which seems to be more widely adopted, specifically around the 3.2 and getting those awesome 2000 plus megabit transfer rates that are coming off of devices like that. Second thing too, overall quality board. RS and Gigabyte make a great board. This is why I'm looking at the $150 to $190 range. This one kind of came in right now at $179.99. Needed to support PCIe Gen 4. You had to have your M.2. I wanted active cooling on the X570, which you have. The other thing that I really like about mainstream builds, mainstream motherboards, is that when you look at the vendor support list for memory, and knowing that you're gonna get 3200 megahertz, 3600 megahertz out of the box, you get a lot better and quality support for higher speed RAM with higher end motherboards. So that is another reason that I chose this, is that looking at the manufacturer's support for memory at that range, this was a better board. That is a motherboard, that is why I chose it. Would love to know what your thoughts are. I know some people are like, why not ASUS? There's so many options here. Honestly, you can't go wrong. I'm just saying that all in likely, you're probably gonna want the $150 to $190 range and then making sure it has USB-C 3.2 Gen 2 support. Here's the interesting thing. For case, you have a choice. I went with NCXT. I really like their cases, and specifically, I like their RGB support. Now, again, I'm not optimizing for RGB, but in this case, when I thought about, hey, if I was going to upgrade this, what is the easiest basically in terms of adding additional RGB support. And right now I think NZXT and Corsair at the top of that list, with NZXT edging it out just a little with the ability to daisy chain their AER RGB fans between them, which makes cable management a whole lot easier. I went with the NZXT H510 Elite. Main reason for that is I didn't have to look at stuff like adding a Corsair Commander Pro or a Lighting Node Pro to add additional RGB support later on. That's not to say if I wanted to add that stuff to the Hue, a lot of that stuff is already built in the NZXT, which made me a lot happier. So that's why I chose the NZXT H510 Elite. Beautiful case, got a lot of tempered glass, overall very easy to build one. You saw that I actually built in the H510 for the 1K version. This is just the much more premium, has a lot more tempered glass. And again, you've got all the nice cable management support in the back. It's got all the channeling, just makes it really easy for a first time builder, which was another kind of thing that I put in this, is like, if this is gonna be your first system, you're gonna spend $2,000, I want you to have a quality experience when you are actually building the PC. Now let's go down to cooler, because if you chose, let's say for instance, you went off the rails and you said, hey, Robey, I don't wanna do NZXT, I wanted to do Corsair, I wanted to do Thermaltake. Here's my deal. When you, well, at least in the case of NZXT and at least in the case of Corsair, if you get a Corsair case, get a Corsair AIO. If I get an NZXT case, I want to get an NZXT AIO. The main reason being is I don't want to install IQ, I don't want to install CAM, I don't want to install 5,000 other RGB controllers. So usually what I did is I tried to minimize the amount of other TSR or TSR memory resident applications like Aura Sync or Mystic Light. Sticking with NZXT, I chose the Kraken X62. If you can get a Kraken X63, that would be more ideal. Right now, those are only for sale on NZXT site. One of the things I wanted to make sure is that you can just go to your cart at Newegg, just hit all add to cart, and you knew you had one fully 2K system ready to go working together. And we'll talk a little bit about that at the end of the video. I hope you're still following along, because we still have a cool thing that's coming up here at the end. NZX2 Kraken X62 280 millimeter. This is gonna be front mounted at the front with those 140 millimeter fans that'll have the RGB support, so I don't have to worry about adding additional fans. I might use one of those 140s at the top just to add a little bit more airflow in the case. Great AIO, I know a lot of people have used it. Their newer one actually supports like Asetek Gen 2, which would be better, but I'm totally happy with using the X62 here. For
memory,
let's talk about memory all up. For RAM, I did the G-Skill Triton Z Neo for AMD Ryzen specifically, a 16 gigs 2x8 configuration at 3600 megahertz. 3600 megahertz is the ideal speed for Ryzen. When you're spending $2,000, you want to get the best bang for the buck. So I went with 16 gigs with two DIMM, 2x8. Main reason being is that if you wanted to add another two DIMMs later on, you could do that and you could have your 32 gigs. $163. Reason I chose Ryzen is that I know it's gonna basically be supported. If you choose this RAM, you will get 3600 megahertz on this motherboard with that CPU. And again, you can't go wrong with G-Skill. G-Skill is a great RAM selection. For M.2 drives, I actually went with Crucial. Couple things are, one, I could choose Samsung and pay the extra money, which means you're gonna get slightly faster transfer speed. Same thing if you chose Seagate Western Digital, or you could do something like Crucial, which is another great hard drive brand. I've used them before, also Intel, and they have a tendency to be cheaper. They're not as fast, but all in all, when we're talking about for gaming and stuff like that, you're not gonna get a whole lot out of it. So spending $69 for a 500 gig OS M.2 NVMe from Crucial was ideal. And then again, I added a 1 terabyte in there, and that's like your game drive. I split it up. This is something I like to do. Here's the deal. One of the things that I think is incredibly important is a lot of people, when they just buy, like, say for instance, you buy a single 2 terabyte OS drive, and then what happens is that you install everything on there, and then as you basically fill up your hard drive, things like Edge or Google or Chrome or all those other things can start causing your system to slow way down. By taking a separate 500 gig and saying, this is my OS drive, making sure all my apps and games go to a second drive, and you get 500 gigs of just plenty of room for your OS to do what it does, you're just nice and safe. You can do the same thing with 256, but you're gonna have some additional things, like maybe you're using Premiere or OBS or stuff like that, that you'll put on that 500 gig drive, and that just gives you plenty of room to kind of stay spaced out. Really, really smart about your hard drive management. So for power supply, Corsair RMX series 850 watt PSU. I wanted to make sure that, you know, like I had a 750 watt for the, I had a 750 watt for the 1K version. I chose 850 watts here, just giving you a little bit more headroom. If you decided you're gonna install the 750 watt, that would be completely fine. You know why? It's got two EPS CPU connectors, which are super important. That's the most critical thing. That's why I don't do 650 or 550, is that those two EPS CPU connectors are gonna be needed for the 10th gen Intel Z490 boards, X570, X670, all those other things are gonna require those two EPS CPU connectors. So that's why we chose at least 750 watts. Ideally, I would say 850 watts. It was worth like the extra $15. When I talked about, like, one of the things I hinted about, I was like, if there's something that I was gonna save for it, the bar that I wanted to keep is I wanted to make sure that we got a RTX 2080 Super card in there. And what I chose specifically is the Gigabyte GeForce RTX 2080 Super. At the time of filming, this was $719.99. Gigabyte makes good cards. I've used them before. I used them in the Warcraft build. I used it in one of my Stormtrooper builds. People have not had an issue with this at all. The other thing too, is that you'll notice that I chose a Gigabyte motherboard, and I also chose a Gigabyte graphics card. And I talked to you really early on about not having a lot of those memory resident programs like Corsair IQ, NZXT Cam Link. So really all I'm doing is I'm installing RGB Fusion, specifically RGB Fusion 2.0, and I'm installing Cam Link. And the cool thing about RGB Fusion 2.0, believe it or not, is that you can install it, change all your colors, and then uninstall it, and it just works. The other thing too is, and I haven't tested this on this board, but and do not quote me if I'm wrong, I apologize, but you can also change with Gigabyte boards, you can change all of your RGB within the BIOS as well. So you can set your colors and not even have to install the lighting program RGB Fusion and be good to go there. 2080 Super means you're gonna be great for 1440p gaming, even pushing 1440p at high frame rates. Placed with the 2080 Super, that means that you can have RTX and still run greater than 60 FPS. Not necessarily at 1440p, but definitely at 1080p. So I wanted to give you some options there. Overall, great card. Looks good too, aesthetically pleasing. And the one thing is that when you look at the overall aesthetics of the build, which was something I did consider here, I wanted to make sure that it would look good. So you basically black card, black motherboard inside of a black and white case. Nothing is gonna clash here. This will actually look pretty good. The last thing I would add, now it's not on here, is some nice cable extensions. If you're gonna build a PC, and if you watch my 1K build, I recommend Asia Horse. Asia Horse makes a bunch of different ones. We'll put a separate link for them down in the description below. It's a $30 that really brings up the aesthetic of the build so much. And there isn't a whole lot you could add $30 here. Maybe the motherboard, maybe the M.2, but for the most part, in terms of just having something that you stare at and that you work so hard on and just looking at it and going, ah, that's beautiful. It's like, that's like every morning when Brian sees me, he's like, ah, that's beautiful. Yeah, sitting in front of the mirror. Yeah, when I sit in front of the mirror, he's like, oh my God, get out of my face. Recommendation, doing that. Now, I told you there's gonna be a treat, some little bit of information here at the end, and here it is. We're gonna build this PC, and guess what? We're gonna give it away. So you need to pay attention and make sure that you watch our live show over at mixer.com/Robeytech and check out our live show, because over there, we are going to be building this PC live on the show. We're also gonna have a build video here on YouTube, and then we're gonna be giving that away starting in March. We're gonna build it in February, and then we'll give it away in March. So make sure you stay tuned to the channel. You're gonna wanna check that out. And you can also follow me over at Twitter at Robeytech, because you're gonna wanna basically check out there. And that's where all of our, all the info for that is going to be. Anyway, guys, what did you think? What did you think of the parts I chose? Again, remember, you have a lot of options here. You could still go Corsair. There's a lot of pathways to take when you're basically choosing parts for a PC at this price range. But what did you think of my selections? What would you do differently and why? Love to hear about all that stuff in the comments below. I spend a lot of time down there. I like to respond and have conversations. If you go check out my 1K build video, which I have linked here, or even the Nook build, you can go check that one out here too. You'll see that I'm down in the comments having lots of discussions. Also, make sure you join us over on our Discord, where we have a lot of those discussions as well. And then again, make sure you hit that subscribe button, whip that like button, ring a notification bell. There'll be all sorts of things that are happening down the screen, and make sure you do that. Check out our live show every Wednesday from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. over at mixer.com/Robeytech. Follow us over on Twitter and Instagram at Robeytech. Hey, I made it easy. It's now all at Robeytech. So that's all a big change. So anyway, guys, and also check us out at facebook.com/Robeytech, or have your parents check us out, because they're probably the only people hanging out. Outside of that, guys, I'm gonna go take off. I got some PCs to build around here, but you guys have a great evening or morning or whatever time you're watching this. We'll check you on the next one. #beefycores.